her daughter, and I would watch it.
Yeah,
it was good times. Yeah, was I had a huge crush on that girl.
I was about to say it's the story of Muskie's first love.
I mean, shit, anyone that watches Sailor Moon's pretty cool in my books.
You're right.
As opposed to, like, all that new weeb stuff out there. I'm not a weeb at all. I'm not a fan of that life. I'm not an...
I watched Attack... We're going to completely destroy the chat.
I like some quick. I like some stuff on, like... I like some anime, like Prototype and...
I watched Attack on... I was about to say, I watched Attack on Titan for the first time.
Sword Art Online.
The other night.
Like that.
That was weird.
Yeah, it's pretty
Attack
weird.
Attack on Titan's super weird.
It's all right. It's not, like, as good as everyone says. I think Death Note's freaking bomb. I don't think Attack on Titan is as good as everyone says it is.
Eh.
But at the end of the day, Sailor Moon is one of the best shows of all time, man.
You're right.
I'm going to let you finish.
You're right. What team is this? What games are this?
This is a repeat of the game that
we
saw before.
Yeah, this is Moon versus Mars. Venus.
Venus, yes.
I believe. Venus.
So let's see what changes in these games. We got the Trundle Band, the Caitlyn Band, the Zed Band, the Swain Band.
I wonder who the Zed Band is targeted at.
Bjergsen, I believe.
It's a Ryu Zed Band.
Do you mind turning me up a little bit? Just type in.
There you go. That should be good, hopefully. I think that was yours.
Because I'm much more important than you. The people deserve to hear me a little bit more than you at all times.
Are you good, you know? That's also an option.
That's true.
All right, the first pick of Moomoo. Insta-lock.
Yo.
Clumsy last game played.
Moomoo is tier one right now. Have you ever heard of Bronzodia?
Yes.
I wonder what we should call the tier of, like, the high tier here. And the solo queue sisters.
Solo queue sisters. It's just a tournament meta, right?
Yeah, but what would we call it? We have a name for the tournament meta. What should we call it? Like the sassy squad?
Lady killers?
The lady killers? That's us, dude.
I don't want to be associated with you if that's how you're gonna throw it down.
Chat, help us out, man. What do we call like the Bronzodia of this tournament here? It's pretty much like Amumu, Sivir.
Leona.
That's like, okay, Amumu, Leona, and, like, I don't know, what's the last one? Let me think really quick.
I mean, Sivir fits.
I guess Swain, kind of.
We've had one Swain game.
No, I think we've had two, haven't we? Maybe it's
no.
Just one.
We've
yeah,
had
it was Bane
Swain
before.
Bands.
It was Bane before, yeah.
It was Bane before. Swain Bane. Was Bane.
Swain is the Bane.
Young Swain Bane.
My vocabulary.
You're trying, and that's what matters.
I'm just hella tired. Either of you weebs seen JoJo's Bizarre Adventure?
No, that sounds...
New.
Sounds
new.
Hyper lame.
To quote... a little bit bizarre for me.
To quote... I don't even know what that's quoting. Angela Anaconda or something like that.
Yeah, that was a weird show.
Ooh, Vlad.
Yep.
A Jin? Are we going to get Vlad and Jin?
Pink Rambo.
I love
you. Pink
see
Rambo.
Jin.
I want to talk to you, actually. Like, I don't even know who you are. I just like the name Pink Rambo. I think you're the coolest person ever, man. I really want to get to know you and show you a good time. Hey. Take you out to dinner or something like that.
Hands off. No means no.
I just really, you know, just got a good taste in movies, man.
And the Jin's locked in.
Yes.
The Jin. I love Jin.
The Jin?
The Jin.
There's the Lux. Lux
another
and
Lux. There we go. There's the Lux that can fit in our. All
right. What could possibly be the last pick here?
So what are we looking for? We're looking for a top laner.
I think
there's
need,
so many.
Yeah,
good
you
picks
need like
open.
A Fiora or something like that that could just dominate this game. Like you need a lot of.
You
damage.
Want more of? You need to team fight something. You need something to team fight with.
I mean something with a lot of damage that can.
Teemo is not it.
There's no
Teemo's
damage.
Really
on this team,
not
man.
It.
Yeah, there's no damage in this team. If
I mean, Lucian does a ton of damage, but it's...
If they lock this in,
there it is.
I think they lose the game. I'm pretty... Okay, so, yeah, I'm pretty sure they lose the flipping game.
The hecking game.
I think they needed, like, a Ryze or, like, something like that. Something
yeah.
that could, like, pump
Ryze
out
Ryze would have
damage.
Been a good pick. Trundle would have been a pretty good pick. It was banned, actually. Just kidding.
Interesting. Okay, so, let's break it down.
Interesting. I'm, again, not going to take a teleport. Hopefully,
Teemo had a rough time last time.
Niskander.
He pushed the Trundle in really hard, and that's probably why they banned it, because they thought that the Teemo would be falling into their strategy, but, you know, Trundle's the one thing that counters it, maybe. Who knows? Something like that. That could be their logic.
Trundle doesn't counter.
Yeah, Teemo. That's what I said. It could be their logic. If they can get Teemo ahead, it can work. They can do, like, a 4-1, I guess, and put, you know, a lot of catch around. I'm worried that there's not going to be a lot of damage. They're definitely going to have to win their lanes. Whereas on the flip side, it's such a good team fighting comp.
Yeah. Jhin, Poppy, Orianna, Braum.
Not to mention all the damage that they would find off of the catches is going to be blocked by the Braum, man.
Yeah, exactly. I feel like they got completely outdrafted here.
I feel like they outdrafted themselves. You know what I mean? And that happens to me a lot. Like, when I go to the club or the bar, and I, like, get in my own head, and, like, I can't even, like, approach somebody. Like, even somebody to just, like, you know, talk to you. Just, like, hey, man, what's up? Like, where are you from? Like, where do you work? Like, you know, what's going on? I think that's what happened to them. They got inside their own head, and they were like, but what if we first pick a Mumu, but what if they pick Janna? And then they just kind of crap the bed, I think.
It's very eloquent of you.
Yeah, sorry. Well, that's what happens. This is exactly the...
You know what I would have liked to see?
It was a reputation of my night, sorry.
You know what I liked? What I would have liked to see instead of the Teemo, apart from, like, pretty much anything? Jace.
Ooh. Jinx? Or Jace? Jace, yeah. Jace is Anito. Yeah. That would have been a siege comp.
That'd
for
be
show.
Fun. And just, but it gives you all that damage that you're pretty lacking, whereas there's a ton of damage on this team. Blue side, which is not Moon. Moon is... What team's on blue side? Trying to get the overlays ready.
We were trying to get female casters Otrek 5. Unfortunately,
we put more focus on finding female players.
Yeah,
we want players.
We also wanted some of the players to hop in and help cast afterwards, mm-hmm. but
we might have for the grand finals.
Also, you know,
some guest casters here.
I'm all about equality, man, and I think that you shouldn't be so
Use
hard
the casters
on me.
You got right.
Yeah, man, you're really hurting my feelings now. I'd appreciate it if you just supported me supporting the women. You know what I mean, dude? Or dudette. I just hope everyone has fun. Especially you. ODREC T5.
Oh, I thought you were talking to me.
No. OTREC 5. You're my favorite viewer in the chat, man.
Or lady.
Or lady. Sorry.
Man or miss.
You know, Kindred would have been a good jungler, too, I think, at that comp.
Kindred,
instead of Mumu.
Kindred doesn't fit really into the tournament meta.
The Bronzodia.
Tournament meta, come on.
Playing well in the champs they pick aren't bronze. Yeah, no, I'm not saying that they are...
No, Bronzodia doesn't...
Yeah.
doesn't
I just mean it's a meta within... it's a meta within
necessarily.
Something. Yeah. Yeah, but, you know, it's cool. You guys can hate on me. That's cool. I like it.
It's all right. That makes me look better.
Yeah, you got to pick somebody to hate on, right? You know what I'm saying?
And you're stuck with them for the rest of the tournament, most likely.
Yeah, you guys. I'm going to be here all day.
Good thing there's only a few games left.
Yep.
We are in loading screen to get ourselves into our loser's bracket final to see who will join... Venus or Jupiter or something like that.
Yeah, so let's break this down. Of course, this is Solo Queue Hero Female Edition, a.k.a. Solo Queue Sisters. And this is a all-female tournament where people sign up individually and they get assigned to a team based on their ELO. All teams are made as fair as possible based on an average ELO throughout the team. And they all come together just to see how they can do as a team on one day. There's no pre-made signups, you're just, you know, going
There were duos options. There was duos. There was a duo option.
Yeah, you do get the duo queue
For anybody wanting to sign up.
But it is you just kind of go for it, man. You just kind of go for the YOLO. Try and see if you've got the skills to pay the bills. And obviously, these two teams are getting called by collection agencies right now, and one of them will be able to pay their bills, and the other one will not be able to pay the bills.
I want to know how this bottom lane matchup is going to go, because I haven't seen a Jhin in a very long time. Jhin's like
a Jhin
lost a lot of
yeah. Did he get
the strength
nerfed,
that he used to have?
Did he get nerfed?
I think
he'll be definitely really good in this matchup.
I don't think he's gotten nerfed. I just think everything that has a little bit of extra mobility has gotten buffed ever so slightly.
So look at this team comp. There's two long range mages that are going to get outranged by Jhin. Like, he's just going to sit way back, and he can just engage with his, or initiate the fight with his ultimate, chunk, like, the entire team, just straight out. And
plus for days.
Yeah, exactly. And, like, the only person they can really stand in front of is an Amumu, and we can't stand in front of everything.
We can finally have a Lux skin that isn't Star Guardian. I don't know what it is about that skin, but I can't
stand. I really don't like the Steel Legion one. Is that Steel Legion one? I didn't
no,
even look at it.
Spell
oh, Spell Thief. This was one of the first skins I ever bought.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, I was a big Lux fan.
The first skin that I ever bought was Wood King Darius.
Wood
or
King or
Woad
King,
King,
yeah.
Whatever you want to call it.
I think there's
it.
A Woad Ash, too.
Yeah, there is a Woad Ash. I don't know where the
Woad,
Woad is.
Woad Ash. Get it.
Woo! All right. Well, then. I mean, we're seeing some aggressive play in the bottom lane.
If Teemo can't win his lane.
Her lane.
It's going to be a unfortunate pick once again. It happened the first time we saw Teemo.
So far they're even.
Didn't learn her lesson or something went wrong. I hope it's the latter. I hope something went wrong. I would love to see a Teemo dominate this game. But
Wouldn't you just
she's
love
lost
to see
a
that.
Lot of CS already. You know, look at the Lux compared to what the Teemo has. That's 15. That's half. That's a wave.
Double the CS.
Yeah,
double the fun.
I don't know, man. I'll believe it when I see it.
As will I. This Jhin laying down so much
ooh,
damage, though.
Ooh, so aggressive. Dashing in. Fourth hit. Does
there
stun. Oh, my goodness. That was aggressive.
Yeah, that Lucian. That's the thing is jumping in on the with the Braum stun. On you is very risque.
There's
a couple of canceled auto attacks by Poppy.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunate.
Teemo not making use of his increased movement speed with his W. I don't even think Teemo actually picked up the W. Yeah, he did. Okay, she did. Because that's one of the big things about Teemo is that you get to continue to trade back. Is this going to happen? Is there an Ignite unlocks? There's not. There's a barrier. One more auto attack.
Lux is out of mana, though.
Two more auto attacks.
Oh, barriers instead of using your
oh, Flash comes out from Lux.
Ability.
And the barrier comes out from Lux. Vi making her way to top. I was going to say, one of the things about Teemo is that you got to utilize your W correctly to really emphasize the trades that anytime they ever commit to you, you got to make it hurt for them by following up a lot with that W. Good snare coming out to Pink Rambo. Vi is just shown top, so they can go all in for this if they want. Heal is not used yet. Oh my goodness, holding on to it to the last second. Still doesn't pop it. Great self-restraint there by our Lucian player. Oh, gets a great Q off, but puts the double auto attack into the Braum, and that is going to make her back off once again. Very, very explosive lanes this time around.
Yeah, that's. I think this Jhin pick
all
is showing
lanes.
The strengths and the weaknesses of the pick,
mm-hmm.
And that it's you know you're very susceptible to hard CC. You get hit by that, and you're
yeah.
a little bit boned.
Yeah.
But also just the sheer damage output that Jhin can provide is pretty bogus. And
ooh.
That was very aggressive.
Yeah.
But Teemo,
the Tito.
Got herself a kill.
Clumsy.
Don't cancel your auto attacks. There you go.
Clumsy off to a better start than she was on that.
On the Elise,
yeah. Definitely.
I actually got some insight into the comms of the team from after that Elise game.
Break down for me.
From what I understand, Clumsy is not an Elise player.
Mm.
She was recommended to pick up Elise by her team.
Unfortunate.
Elise is a good pick. Yeah, Elise is a great pick, but if you don't know how to play it,
yeah, Yeah, I've been there before.
Don't know how to play it.
Yeah, I did that in Italy the last tournament I was at.
Did yeah?
I first blood, and then I got first blood and was like, oh, yeah, and tried to dive two towers and died both times.
Well, I mean, that's that seems like a you problem.
Yeah. Yeah, it could be.
Yeah.
Don't do a queue with me, ladies and gentlemen. I'm warning you.
I would never.
I am a menace to the Rift.
I'm not high enough rank to do a queue with you.
I thought you were going to say you're not high enough something else. Lol.
I don't even get it.
As in, you'd have to be on drugs to do a queue with me. Yeah.
I mean, that too.
Yeah. That was pretty straightforward, but whatever.
Whatever. Teemo is not changing the build from.
No, that's fine. I think it's an okay build. It's
fine,
build,
but Nashor's Tooth is just so good.
Yeah.
It's just such a good item on Teemo.
Mm-hmm. Really helps push the wave in, too, which is where Teemo wants to be. Mm-hmm. We got to keep in mind that the Lux is down her flash, and Vi is about to hit level 6.
That's a good point. We haven't seen any Vi ganks yet, and Vi does not have to be level 6 to have an impactful gank.
Here we go.
Ooh.
There is the ultimate used. The barrier is just about up from Lux. There it is. Oh, great ulti. The burn is going to tick down. There is the Vi, not level 6. Misses the Q, actually flashes first instead of queuing and then flashing. And that's going to be a missed attempt. And they kind of missed their window as well because they went before Vi was level 6. And now, with no flash and no ulti, kind of a
I feel like if Vi had hit that, it would very easily bait Orianna into re-engaging. And
well, Ori did have her barrier up still, so. Definitely could have gone okay.
I thought I had seen it wasn't up at the time, but I could be wrong.
Oh, good shield by Braum, but at the same time, the shield blocks Lux and not the Lucian, and this could be a. Oh, I was feeling it. Just a single kill. A lot
for
a single kill, but
gets
they should.
What kill?
Yeah.
And lane pressure, that's important.
Yeah,
it
so tell me about
Jhin
this.
Out of lane.
Tell me about this Dargan they're about to pick up. Right, I hope they pick up after the blue buff.
It is a Cloud Drake. Cloud Drake is one of those ones that you'll get just so that you can cycle it out. You can like get it out of the way so that another dragon can spawn.
Yeah. You know what they call it when you cycle it out?
What?
It's called working on your cadence.
Working on your cadence?
Yeah. It's a cycling reference for you.
Okay. I was gonna say, you getting a spicy meme on me right
no,
now?
No, no. It's like the consistency that you can keep the speed up on your rotations on your cycling.
As in on a bike.
Yeah.
Gotcha.
Yeah.
Well, we're not talking about none of them real sports. We're talking about e-sports. We're talking about the biggest, the OGs.
Fair enough. Yeah, nobody cares after the whole Lance Armstrong debacle.
Teemo, despite the fact that
comes by,
she's gotten herself an early, got herself the solo kill, and has
by.
Chunked her out, chunked Lula's out the Poppy. Down.
Good job by Chocoberry. That's confident mid play right there. Seeing that the Vi's top, realizing that Amumu is going to come counter gank that, tries to find some vision when she has time based off the position of other people on the map. Vi level 6, still not used her ultimate yet. Stand
yeah, she's only ever attempted one gank, flashed Mr. Q.
Yeah.
And it was no bueno.
Yeah.
That
unlucky.
Long range W
unlucky.
From Jhin being big boys.
And yet again, we are witnessing another very slow game here at Solo Q Sisters.
20, I mean, the winner of this 16. Goes to the grand finals. Loser is out. And, you know, I did say before that this is all about, you know, having fun and meeting people and,
in
you know, developing a sense of community. But winning is still nice.
Yeah. I won one of these once, and it was so
you won a Solo Q Sisters
fun.
Once?
Not a Solo Q Sisters, but a Solo Q Hero. I won it with my friend Zot. You're on the same team.
We
played really well. We just had a really great team. We synergized very well. Everything kind of went to plan. We never had any issues, and it was just so much fun to win at the end of it. It's so rewarding, and just the adrenaline and exhilarating and everything
plus
like that.
Triumphant rise, though.
Yep.
Yep. Clumsy. Going for the gank. Does have flash available. Here's the Vi. She goes in onto that Lucian. The ultimate comes out from Clumsy, but it's a little bit too little too late. The ultimate actually pulling Clumsy away. Here comes the Jhin ult. Curtain Call does find one onto the Lucian. Flashes the second one. Third one comes out. And the fourth hit is not going to find anything. So it's just going to be the one kill in exchange for quite a few summoner spells. And Poppy kept at her tower top. Ooh, Chocoberry getting very low, but they find a lot of pressure onto the Lux. And oh my goodness, they find the perfect binding as well. Clumsy going to chicken out of this one, but a turnaround brings it to 1-1 at the end of the day.
Jhin had so much pressure in the lane, and then he just kept getting ganked and ganked and ganked and ganked and then ganked again. This is why we stopped seeing Jhin. You're just going to get ganked, and then if you get pushed back to tower, you're going to get dope. And there's nothing you can do to stop it. Meanwhile, Teemo, whew, is that mastery level 7?
I didn't even know that was a thing.
Mastery level 7.
What a god.
It's the highest mastery level you can have on a champion recently released. You have to get S minus or S or S plus to get a...
Just once, or?
Well, you get a token for getting an S minus to an S plus, like a rank 6 token. And if you get two of those, then you can convert them into rank 6 mastery on a champion. And then you have to get S or S plus, I believe.
Why is League of Legends turning into World of Warcraft?
Because it can. I mean, it's already like CS:GO with all the boxes and crates and whatnot.
Mm.
It was only a matter of time.
Interesting.
Successful games. Whatever.
Whatever. I do what I want.
You what?
Sassy solo queue. All right. Teemo's finally starting to run away with his lane, but still down in CS.
Yeah, still down 10 CS.
That's so bad. I mean, I don't mean to call it out, but like, if you're going to pick that champion, you got to work on your CS. You gotta work on your CS.
And then we didn't have our ulti there. Otherwise, it'd be a dead poopy.
Because unless you're getting kills, like, you're still, like, not going to be very relevant. Like, a Poppy down a few hundred gold is still more relevant
than
a Teemo.
Yeah, it's going to jump in a team fight and
yeah,
kill a bunch of stuff. You know, can cancel a Moomoo Q with her steadfast presence. Can cancel a Lucian dash as well.
Yep.
Higher impact pick.
Here we go. See how Teemo plays this. This is the sign of a good Teemo if you can outplay a gank like this. Oh, but the CC is real.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go. There's one. Now can he do it? Into the mushroom.
Tight.
Oh, just out of range.
Teemo flash.
The thing about Teemo into the Vi is that your Q will prevent the E damage from coming out from the Vi as well because it's blind, right? So.
Because E is still just an empowered auto attack. Mm.
So very close, actually. I would not have been surprised if that was a 1v2 outplay. So, you know, I'm saying it, but she's picking up those kills. Slowly but surely, making this Teemo work.
It's happening.
It's happening. Yeah, for sure. Amumu checking that Vi, making her stay honest. Not letting her get any extra camps before she goes back. And that's going to allow her to take the soon-spawning red buff, and maybe get some vision in towards that Orianna. But Lux is going bottom at the same time, so she's got a chance to do a really good gank here. She's about to run over the ward, but look, there's nobody near to contest. Nobody to back this up. If their bottom lane goes, this could be a huge play. Finds the shield stun, the stun onto the shield, and Braum does jump into a minion and just misses the E.
Invested so much, invested in exhaust. Yep. That exhaust was very overzealous.
Orianna is rotating towards bottom right now.
And that means that Clumsy is free to get 1v1'd by this Vi.
A good engage there, but there's the Orianna. Maybe it was more of a bait than anything. Mayari going to get taken down for a little bit of overzealousness.
Jelly Booger, is she all right? Appears she gets out fine. Lux is now re-rotating down to the bottom lane.
Yo, Rotato.
She can pick something up off the back end of that.
Rotatoes. She's low mana, though. And
now Jelly Booger.
Yeah.
just got baited into dying again.
Yeah. It seems like there's some it's just a little bit of miscommunication. Yeah. These guys trying to make plays, not taking into account everything, you know, low mana, such like that. It's like, yeah, no, we can do it. Unfortunately, doesn't seem like many more of those mistakes can go without, you know, really affecting the team.
Uncalculated aggression.
Mm-hmm.
I use that term a lot, but it is...
Maybe that should be my strategy when I go to the bar.
Uncalculated aggression.
Yeah. Just in terms of, like, the words that I'm saying. Not actually being aggressive, but I'd be like, you know, I'd just be like...
Teemo, don't die.
Put myself out there.
All right. Oh, wow. Teemo actually...
Yeah, Teemo's
very nearly killed her. One more auto attack would have killed.
Yeah, Teemo's definitely putting in an overdrive right now. This is where we saw the Trundle start really winning against the Teemo last time. But even with that CS deficit, really starting to escalate the pressure in this matchup.
And the Poppy pick not having nearly the same split push impact that
the
Trundle
Poppy pick
has
for purple
potentially.
Play? Purple side Poppy pick.
Purple side Poppy pick.
Man,
Orianna's level 11 to Lux's level 10.
Yeah,
so
a
5v5
attention bottom lane. She's also got a big item up on her in that Needlessly Large Rod. Mm-hmm.
But it's Morella and Omicron against Needlessly Large Rod. I think I'd rather have a Morella.
Yeah, fair enough.
Than
good point.
Or
you're
a
right.
Completed Morella.
Yeah, definitely.
Some components.
Definitely.
It's buying.
Right. Oh, good find.
Orianna's just buying like pieces of a bunch of different items. Bought the tier and then bought the last Lost Chapter. And then now with the Rod of Ages, presumably going into Archangel Staff.
So much attention toward this bottom lane, which is a really good idea because that Teemo doesn't have TP, so they can make plays around the map. That's a good idea. That's a good sign, I'd say. From the red team. Any sort of plays they can make bottom lane, utilize that TP disadvantage would be phenomenal.
There's this Cloud Drake is still up.
Yeah.
But there's no point taking it. It doesn't
Maybe
have
they're racist
an impact.
Against clouds.
Well, it doesn't have an impact. That's one of the community's largest criticisms.
You know who doesn't have an impact anymore?
I'm waiting.
Energy, yeah. It was an LCS beam.
Just trying to
fill the dead air.
That was good.
Oh, nice one, iGirl does get
CC.
Oh,
you're gonna get the dive.
The ignite comes out, or is not available, rather. It's just the burn.
All right. That's mastery level 7 Teemo. Holy moly.
Show that mastery. Oh, here we go. Fight bottom lane. And that... Poppy said so there's no going to be a TP.
Shield the wrong way, bro.
Shield the wrong way, bro. Good binding on that snare. Here comes the curtain call, but it's just not going to be enough damage. Just doesn't have the items right now. He's got the IE, but he needs more to be able to really chunk. Great ultimate from Lux. This Lux, man. I've been very impressed with Luxes in this tournament.
I mean, there's been a lot of them.
There has been. It's Lux, Leona, and Amumu is... The Solo Q Sister Triforce.
Solo Q Sister Triforce.
That should. We'll put that on the next poster. All right, John. Remember that. That's the okay. Okay.
He gave a thumbs up.
Yeah.
He's got a nice hairband on. Looks really cute on you. Hey, don't knock that over. Please
That's
and thank
the plug
you.
For the whole computer.
Nice. He didn't do it.
So Poppy 0-4 against the 4-1 Teemo, who now has climbed up to just about the top CS on his team. Her team.
Yeah, gotten an advantage. That's the thing, is that when you're in lane and your enemy's not.
But she's not
spreading shrooms anywhere.
But,
it's just like, I'm going to make this top lane miserable.
I like it. But she needs to take that tower. She needs to take it to the next stage of the game. Because she's going to be a deficit to her team. If she can't team fight, she can't split push. She needs to take that tower. She needs to get going quick.
Toss.
Here comes the engage from Kloomzy. Oh my god, that ultimate doing so much damage.
Auto off.
There's the Lux popping off. And they really should not win this 2v2, but it looks like they are. If the CC lands, get the Q to interrupt the Q. Great work. Here comes the
nice.
Poppy. And this is where the Teemo comes at a disadvantage. Teemo puts down the question mark, but is it enough? I don't know if iGirl is going to be able to get out of this one alive. If the Q hits, it does.
But she has Ma Malmordius.
Yeah, you're right.
Fine.
The Ma should keep her safe. Jeez, there's the spooky ghosts. It's
crazy.
Spooky ghosties.
So
you mean this
damage.
Pink Rambo?
Oh.
Alti.
Oh. The
ulti's
is she
up.
Using
the
it?
Ulti's up, yeah. Too far out of range, I think, now.
Wow. That would have been exciting. See if she could get the blind snipe off.
Alright, Tito. Tito putting out the deeps. Ooh.
Morgana.
Very aggressive.
Ulting, walking in, and flashing out.
That's
and
a kill. That's a
kill.
Goodbye. Whoa. That was weird.
Unnecessary flash, but weird. You know what? Just going to show this Poppy who's boss.
Yeah,
I'm this.
I love it.
I'm the king of this top
Tito
lane.
Making me,
this top lane.
Tito making me proud right now. Tito making me proud.
Tito. Oh, this is an AP Mumu. That's a Runic Echoes of Mumu.
Heck yeah, dude.
Oh, my goodness.
I love it.
Lux got caught by the, or Orianna getting caught by the binding.
I love AP Mumu. It's really strong, especially when they're down so much damage and they've got, you know, kind of a lack in damage in their team fight. Mm-hmm. I think going AP Mumu is really good.
But if you're going to go AP Mumu, I think you need Abyssal Scepter ASAP.
They don't have that much AP damage, though. I would go for a little bit of health.
They don't have that much AP damage. They got Teemo and they got Lux and they have Morgana.
No, I mean on the other team for the MR. I think there's a lot of MR on this Mumu right now that doesn't need to be there, in my opinion. I would go... I'm only saying this because I am an AP Mumu player. I would go for the double pen. So instead of the Haunting Guy, or instead of the Boots 3, I would go for double pen items. I'd get Haunting Guys for a little bit of health with also the pen. And I'd also get Magic Pen Boots stacks with your passive, which
Say
does...
Say pen again.
Pen?
There you go. Thank you.
A Mumu's passive is 20 Magic Pen when you auto-attack. I think it scales on 6, 11, and 18, or 6, 16. And you can stack a lot of pen, and... build it into a Rylai's and Azonia's, and then build situational off that, because there's not that much magic damage, you know? You're going to be taking a lot of damage mostly from the Jhin and the Vi, I would say.
Orianna deals a lot of magic damage when it gets later in these teams.
Yeah,
fights.
Later for sure, but, you know, 3 MR items right now, 2 MR.
Oh, Morgana.
A little bit
Hello.
Overzealous. Yeah. Jelly Burger, a little bit overzealous. Stays a little bit too long. Here comes the Orianna. Let's see if the MR works. Clumsy might need to go in to peel that Orianna. Oh, a good ultimate. Flash engage from Clumsy. Actually finds the ulti as well. There's no abilities left from the Lux, however. There's the Q. Finds it onto both. Oh, my goodness. Unfortunately, she just doesn't have the damage, and that is going to be a double kill from Jhin. Great
Flashing
shots.
Red all over the place. But
yeah, great shots from Lilith and the rest of the team. They really had it on point. It's
for
just
zero and a tower trade. And maybe they'll finally take this dragon to cycle it out. Yeah. Great. This dragon's been here since the beginning of the game. Poor Cloud Drake. So lonely. You really just want to take that as
Are
early
you promoting
as possible.
Violence against dragons?
In this computerized video game, yes.
Yeah, it's a simulation of real life, okay, right here. This, the you know, just stop. Stop it
it's
with the
an
dragon.
Exaggerated
stop
simulation.
It with the dragon fin soup,
sure.
Okay?
An
Save
exaggerated
the dragons.
Something. I don't simulation.
Are you okay?
There we go.
Are you all right?
I think I just had a stroke real quick.
All right, so breaking
Sorry,
it down, 10 to 9, 25 minutes in, 1,000 gold lead. These games are so close all the way through this tournament. These teams are very evenly matched. And really, it's just, you know,
yeah,
who,
it's 200
adapts, who adapts to these team fights best throughout the games? And, I you know, this time around, having that Teemo is so significant if she can split push. But she's grouping right now. So I don't know if maybe she's really good at teamfight Teemo. Really, like, you know, level 7 mastery. Like, I as a Shaco player, feel like I can teamfight with Shaco because I played him so long. I played him well enough that I know certain opportunities that I can teamfight. So Teemo's rotating down. She's got that level 7 mastery. She knows that this is the time she should be with her team.
Highest level in the game, level 15.
Yeah. Trying to affect the,
Hopefully
you know,
going to throw down some shrooms somewhere
throw a lot of the gold
outside
is.
Of the top lane.
Throw a lot of the gold is. So they're going to put some attention towards this mid lane as 5. Jin's going to rotate over there. They're going to siege up, drop the mushrooms. Maybe they can have the mushrooms as sort of a disengage tool as well.
As this game goes on, though, I can't help but feel like the red team is going to outscale just because, strictly because of the Orianna scaling and the Jhin scaling. Jhin gets a lot of mobility once he gets his 100% crit from his passive with all the extra move speed that he gets.
Yeah.
And this Lucian build does not scale well, and she's super far behind in it as well.
Yeah, no, I think, you know, like I was saying about the Shaco, actually, very similar to that. Like, you can play Shaco as sort of a weird disengaged champion, especially if you're playing AP Shaco. You can drop mush, or you can drop boxes behind in a siege comp situation. So when they chase after you, when they engage, they run into the boxes, they get slowed down. It's the same thing with shrooms, right? Mm-hmm. How are you going to chase into shrooms? So I actually do kind of dig this. It's just, it's a little bit unorthodox, that's all. But they've got two bindings, you know, you hit one binding, you're going to hit the other. And with enough poke, you can follow up the culling, and then the Amumu will go in. And Teemo's really just a disengage and another auto attacker. So I really am kind of digging this right now. Just got to find that lasting poke damage. And there's a lot of wave clear from that Orianna, pretty much the whole team, really.
Yeah, from the Lux, from the Lucian, from the Orianna, and from the
Vi as well,
even.
Too.
And the Vi a little bit, yeah. They're just going to A-ram it up.
So to just take this into like the next level of depth, here is the two minion waves that are going to be pushing, right? So it's going to be a trade. However, this opens up because they're pushing, they can rotate into the top side and they can take vision around there based on how this goes. They are wasting a lot of mana right here. They don't have blue buff. So Lux throwing out ability after ability after ability is going to run And now it's actually quite heavily in the favor of the red team. Which I can't remember which the red team is right now. Team Mars, I believe. Could be wrong.
Mars versus Venus?
Yeah, I believe the red team is Venus. But regardless, oh my goodness, here comes the Vi into the back line onto the Lux. That's what I'm talking about. They're out of mana. They don't have the damage they can now put. Teemo does get a kill. That's six onto her.
It's a 2-for-1.
Yes.
Braum for Amumu.
Yes. And Amumu didn't even get to ulti. It was just an unfortunate kind of situation, and that still brings the Jhin
up, still adult up, yeah.
That brings the Jhin to 6-3. Not bad at all. And Poppy's gonna catch a huge wave top. Oh my goodness, Nick Sander going in. Oh, good dodge by Pink Rambo. Oh, Pink Rambo gets
right
sniped out. Mind gamed.
He had flash up. She had flash up.
Yeah, I was gonna say Poppy's gonna catch a huge wave up here. Bring yourself within a little bit more CS towards that Teemo. Save that wave. Aggro. Really good plays by these teams. Honestly, I'm very impressed throughout this entire tournament. This is actually some of the highest level solo queue hero tournament that I've seen. Highest level play in solo queue hero tournaments that I've seen. Just overall, the level of skill here is very high.
Mm-hmm.
Very impressed with the females of Toronto, the ladies.
Me as well. This is I'm pleasantly surprised to see this out of a solo queue tournament, period. Generally, when we get a solo queue tournament, it's just like a bunch of players who kind of do their own thing.
Yeah.
And see what happens.
You know, maybe it has something to do with the psychology, but I was talking about this a little bit earlier. When you talk about, like, we were talking about the Teemo pick in the first game, I was saying generally females are a little bit less confrontational. Maybe they wouldn't be, like, against the Teemo pick. They'd be like, yeah, sure, if you feel like you can do it, like, they're easier to work with as a team, I'd say. Maybe I'm you know, making a mistake here and assuming or whatever, but that's kind of how I interpret it. To be like a little bit more willing to try something like a Teemo as opposed to a team full of, you know, cocky guys that are trying to win and be the star of the game. But if these girls, as they seem to be, so able to work together as a team, they're doing pretty damn well as teams. The individual play might not be as high. The CS is a little bit lower, things like that. But even, like, there's not really a mechanical difference. Like, I could, you know. There's no, obviously there's no difference, but just saying, these guys play very well as a team. That's all.
That's a very long-winded way of saying that.
Yeah.
But I agree. That's all.
I probably came off sexist there. I was trying to be last one. Who knows?
He tried.
Yeah. I mean, well.
I'd like to see a lot more sweepers. A lot more sweepers on this team. Braum is already level 12, doesn't have an upgraded sweeper, and everybody else has a yellow trinket ward. Get some sweepers against a Teemo. Especially a Teemo who's 6-1 with two items, one of them being Rabadon's, the other being Liandry's. It's just a matter of time before she gets I don't know, whatever else she feels like buying.
Ooh,
staff.
Pink Rambo. Interesting positioning here. I like this a lot, actually, though.
Flank.
Oh, the angle was awkward on the ulti. Should have angled it back towards, you know, you knew they were going to disengage. That's awkward because obviously it's like a cone, right? Mm-hmm. So it's, yeah, unfortunate. But I liked it.
That
was really
also
cool.
Pretty risky, though.
It was, but the Lucian was top lane, and they're all squishy, right? And that's the thing. Like, Lucian's going to be – or, sorry, not Lucian. The Jhin's going to be so good against this team because he can do so much damage from range against the squishy targets. And that's going to be the second dragon going over to Team Mars here. And
Clumsy may be able to get a steal. Not quite.
Not worth it. Not worth it at all, I'd say.
And Lilith.
Ooh! Lux didn't have her ulti there. That could have been bad. Lucian gets the wave going. I like that. Bottom wave is also going in the favor of blue side. That's Team Venus, I believe. Venus and Mars, I think this is the rematch. I'm sorry if I'm messing up the names. But if they can utilize both these wave pushes, you can see Poppy going for the top wave, and somebody might need to go for the bottom wave. At the very least, they can see how low that tower is. If it's low, they can let the minions deal with it. Otherwise, they can rotate towards it, get a play in mid, and then rotate towards bottom. Poppy with the TP. It's the only thing you need to be careful of. Good Q on to the Jhin. Forces the QSS out. Sorry to cut you off there.
That's all right. The Poppy's... My concern is that the Poppy doesn't really have any tank stats, so flanking on that Poppy is a 0-5 Poppy with Malmortius.
She's going to be the one cleaning up the fights, I hope, to get back in the game a little bit. Because really the damage is going to be coming from the Jhin and the Ori, right?
Yeah, for sure. Both of them very high damage scaling threats. If they can...
Flash Wars out from Morgana there. Is able to live. And let's look
they
at that bottom
those
wave.
Team fights the way they want them, and Jhin can have his grenade bounce around.
Bottom wave doing a lot of damage. We did check on that tower just a minute ago. Everything counts.
This Vi has quietly picked up a lot of kills for herself.
I think, you know, something that we kind of lacked to pay attention to is these mushrooms. They are going to become very relevant if Teemo is able to place them in the right places and kind of use them as little objective tools, right? Place it around a Baron, place it around a Dragon, place it around a Tower, like we were saying earlier. But
that's just another, it's an added aspect of vision control. Same with Jhin and...
But, I mean, also if you bait them into it, into the fight, you know, if you kite, disengage with it, I think that's very important. However, a single pink ward, if they're all placed in the same mid lane like this, can really ruin a Teemo's day.
I wonder if Braum is going to remember to get a sweeper.
I sure hope so.
I would an upgraded sweeper, rather. Really like to see that.
Mm-hmm. It's like when you play against a Rengar, like you just always have to have a pink ward beside you.
Yeah.
Or a Collier or something similar. I would love to see a blue buff get picked on Lux before they start sieging mid like this, because really they're not having the luck that they want, and they're kind of just falling into...
They're just 5v5-ing, A-ramming it, yeah.
Yeah, but the thing is, it's delaying the game a lot because there's no pressure anywhere else. There's nothing that they need to worry about on the peripherals. You need to maximize the situation. If you're going to do this, do it on an item spike, get blue buff, get your waves pushing on both sides, and then go. And right now, they've dedicated 3 people out of lane for pretty much no reason.
And Lucian has finally rotated down to the bottom lane, seeing if she can maybe... just finish off that tower bot to help open up the map a little bit.
Yeah, just kind of awkward stuff right here. We see Teemo going back to split pushing a little bit, which, you know, I think is good, but needs to utilize those mushrooms, get some vision control. Like, if they want to fight, they should fight, and they should use it in an advantageous situation, like you know, around Baron with the mushrooms there, or in mid with the blue buff unlocked so they can poke, or... let Teemo split push or get the waves going. And they've finally done that. Lux is getting blue. Okay, perfect. This is exactly what I'm talking about here. They've got top wave going. They've got bottom wave going. Bottom wave will take down that tower by itself. They've got blue buff on Lux. Morgana does not have flash. So let's see them poke.
They got blue buff on Lux, but they got blue buff on Orianna too, which means Orianna can reposition her ball again. And ball control is extremely important when you're playing Orianna. You can sneak it in there.
Yeah.
Just the little tiniest movement and alt, and then suddenly all four.
They really need to not force the fight. They just need to poke. Poke, 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 poke. Oh my god, they group up a huge Vi ultimate. There's the Braum ultimate. Clumsy goes in, gets the deep ult from the Amumu, and that lines up a Lux ult. But at the end of the day, it's going to be the red team, aka Team Mars, that's pushing in deep. And they will get the one kill for none at the moment, but it's not over yet. Lilith has so much health right now. And, you know, they've got some protection for the Lucian, too, if they go for the overextension. Here comes the ultimate. Curtain call. So good. Here comes the Vi over the wall. They find one, and I don't think they'll find the other. The flash comes out from Tarazia, the Chilling Smite. That is going to be another one, unless Lux has something to say about it. One more. The shield comes back. The Q misses. I don't know what went with that fight. I mean, I feel like it was such a good opportunity for Team Jupiter there.
Yeah, great opportunity to sort of make the wow, Lux just very, very nearly killed Chuckleberry. Not quite though. It was very close. That team fight could have very easily gone either way.
I personally think
just
that
execution on the Jhin. I think the Jhin is actually the thing that won them that team fight. The damage coming out of that.
The Amumu lined up
execute damage
on
that.
The Amumu lined up onto the Orianna for a Lux ult, but it only hit one carry. I feel like there just needs to be more poke. When you've got, you know, we talked about this, like every time that the Lux ultimate is up, it's on a 30-second cooldown with blue buff. You know, literally a 30-second cooldown with blue buff. If I check right now, it's 48 seconds without blue buff. An extra 10% CDR is like, you know, 35 seconds. They just really need to chunk people, poke people, use that. They don't have any sustain. Speaking of sustain, here comes another insane fight. The Orianna ult actually seems like it missed everybody, but it was so close to being a five-man ultimate there. And now Lucian's in so much trouble. Lux doesn't have her ultimate available. Oh, no. Everything is coming on Milhouse this game.
Jhin flash
forward. Is that a double kill off the mushroom? A single kill only, but this is what I'm talking about. We gotta play into these mushrooms. The blue team is just not playing into their strengths of their team comps. They're just trying to brute force it. And this is an issue with leadership. I gotta tell you, this is what happens in Silky tournaments. When you see the people that have the proper teamwork, the proper leadership, those are the guys that come out on top. Those are the girls, excuse me, who come out on top. Bottom lane, huge wave pushing top lane. Huge wave pushing in the third dragon. Looks like it's going to go over unless Clumsy has something to say about it. She goes in. The smite actually goes over to Lux, so it's for her team. And this might be a huge cleanup for Teemo. 8 kills on her. Maybe 9 in a second. They got another banish toss, but it's not going to be there. And that's going to be, I believe, a disengage from Team Jupiter.
Elder Dragon is a very difficult objective to take. It is extremely tanky. It has more HP, and it deals more damage than Baron. Maybe not deals more damage, but it takes way longer. Baron, you can melt. Elder Drake, you can kind of not. That was very overzealous. I don't think they realized when they started it that it was an Elder Drake. Because I didn't.
It's after 35, right?
It's anyone that spawns after 35. I thought that maybe there was one that had respawned before that. But since the first dragon was taken so late, not quite as such. But
so what does the Elder Dragon do to a team that hasn't had any dragon, if that's their first dragon?
You get a damage burn. You get 45.
So it's like a fifth dragon.
It's
but just the fifth dragon bonus.
Kind of like a fifth dragon, but just a fifth dragon. It's like a fifth dragon junior.
Oh, speaking of a fifth dragon junior, Pink Rambo is going to get caught out here. Is it enough? There's the binding. QSS is not used at all. It was up. It was available. It wasn't used. Oh my goodness, a panic coming out from the Jhin there. Jelly Booger flashes early, but it doesn't matter. She does get the disengage off. There's the exhaust. Clumsy, without an ult, is going to go down. Oh my goodness, the CC, the damage, the AoE, and this is huge for Team Mars, but look at the top lane. Lucian's up there. This is not the end of the world. They might be able to trade some objectives. There's nothing on the bottom side of the map for Team Mars to get unless they just push this bottom wave through. What are they going to do? Again, this comes down to the leadership I was talking about. These are the calls, the shot calls, the things that decide the tournament. Lucian should be able to get that top lane tower.
And the person who can push the wave back to try and protect the tower didn't even protect the tower, and now it's Braum, Poppy, and Vi to try and take that tower. Tower's relatively low. They should be able to get it.
I do like what Teemo's doing right here. I do like that he picked up the Scuttle Crab. She picked up the Scuttle Crab. I think that's very important for the next few minutes of this game, securing that vision, because the team is going to be kind of in a weird situation.
And when you take one of those epic objectives, your goal is to
blue buff on Teemo.
Okay, well, blue buff on Teemo I mean, I prefer it on Mux, to be frank.
I definitely prefer it on Teemo for the increased mushroom droppage, considering he hasn't got a lot of CDR either. I want to see... Right. That's where all the gold is. Let's take a look at the gold really quickly. La 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 la. I can't remember the keybind. X. Look at all of that gold on Teemo. 14,000. Highest gold in the game. If they can utilize that gold in zone control around a Baron objective, force a Baron, control the vision, team fight on the mushrooms, there's no way they can lose.
Ideally, yes. In an
no,
ideal
money
world, there's
shit.
No way
I'll put
they
money
can
on
lose.
That. I'll put money on that right now.
But that's the
I
thing. They still have to execute it.
That's true.
There's a red ward in the
Executor.
Baron pit. They've got Scuttle Crab.
Who does Executor evolve out of?
Execute?
Yes, good work. I think it's something else, but...
No, whatever. It's Execute.
And then Executor?
Executor, yeah.
Yeah, you're right.
It's like the least
creative
Pokemon names.
All right, fair enough.
That and Garbodor. Ooh, Lux.
And Ditto.
Lux chunked... Lux chunked Orianna to, like, half HP
but
just
now
with
they're
the
trying to poke with the blue buff on the other dude. I don't get it, man. Put Mushroom somewhere and force the objective. Tag me in, coach. Let me go talk to the team.
No coaching.
No coaching. I think they're changing that with, like, one of the LCS regions, eh? Like, you're allowed to, like, have, like,
there's
coaches
coaching
in
stage?
The comms.
Really?
Like, in LMS or something like that. Something weird like that.
Level 14.
Maybe it's Counter-Strike. I think it's Counter-Strike that's like that, actually. Yeah, Counter-Strike is the one that did that.
Braum still doesn't have an upgraded sweeper.
Coaches.
At 41 minutes.
Well, you know, these mushrooms haven't really been a huge factor, so.
You are correct.
There we go.
There he
one.
Goes. He steps on one.
She but no follow-up. All right. Big wave bottom. Really good. Now imagine that they had this big wave bottom and mushrooms around Baron, because then they could go to Baron and somebody would have to either force to engage in on them. Look at this. Look how big this wave is. I'm sorry, but like, look how big this wave is. This is so much pressure. JK. Orianna kills the Lux. I did miss that. I apologize. I was too busy focusing on this bottom wave. But they could still even contest this
4v5. Top wave is being matched, and they already those minions already took the tower.
But you could utilize it so much better on bottom wave.
You
can go contest Baron.
Oh, that's really deep.
Lucian is getting hit. There's the Zhonya's on Jellybugger. She gets the ultimate onto just the Vi. Here comes the Poppy trying to get involved in that fight. Knocks Clumsy out towards the Orianna. On the flip side, Nyxander is able to take down the Vi. And now they run into the mushroom, finally. And Mayari looks like she's going to go down to the Poppy as well. But Nyxander might be able to clean this up with Clumsy. She should be able to.
And Poppy has finally gotten tanky enough. Oh, I thought
Banish Toss.
I thought she was getting minion taxi over. Teemo?
She had Smite.
There it is.
Smite.
Gives it off Smite. To the Teemo. 11-1-3 on the Teemo.
Lux is going to get a lot of gold here.
3K in the inventory. There's so much gold to spend. Amumu with 2K. Teemo with 3. Morgana with 1.3.
Fourth hit missed on the Teemo. All three hit except for the fourth.
Just barely dodges it.
Oh, tag me in, coach. Let me talk to the team.
But that was worst case scenario for blue team. Or for red team, rather. Jin and Braum both got chunked out before the fight even started. Ori only got an ulti on one person.
Yeah, it's true. We haven't seen any good Orianna ultimates. There was one at Dragon that was like inches from being a godlike five-man Orianna ultimate. But I think
three is enough.
I think...
For it to be a good ulti, three is enough. Especially considering that you have three... high threats, or three like top tier threats on the blue side, and getting at least one of them, ideally all three, but getting at least one of them, I think, is enough.
Alrighty, 45 minutes into the game, 20 kills to 22, a 1,200 gold differential between these two teams.
Which at 44 minutes is nothing.
Well, just regardless, it's so close. These games have been so even, and this is the Lunar's losers final. And also the Battle of the Lunar, I guess.
Let's call it bottom bracket. No one's a loser.
Bottom
here.
Bracket.
Everyone's
right.
A winner.
Redemption
bracket. There you go.
Like
I like that.
And there's starting to utilize these mushrooms around Baron. Thank you. Maybe they're ghosting the stream.
There's two upgraded sweepers picked up. on the red side.
A good opportunity here.
Upgraded it.
A really good opportunity here. Orianne Ultimate does get zoned. It only hits Clumsy. Literally useless. And here comes iGirl. She goes in, but there's Clumsy going in deep. 1v3, taking a lot of time over here. Let's take a look at the other side of the map. There's Lucian dealing with the other two divers. And it looks like it's going to be just a disengage coming out from Team Jupiter here. Millimeters away from hitting that snare. Big ulti, actually. A good chunk onto everyone. Yeah. It's not over yet. However, a lot of ultimates down.
Still a 5v4. Morgana's dead for another 30 seconds.
Yeah, a lot of ultimates down. Look at the big wave top, though. There's so much wave control in
this
game. Look
at that top wave, though.
Yeah, that's what I mean. There's a lot of wave control here. So if they can push them back and maybe start to contest the Baron immediately, fight them. If they win and they capitalize on a fight topped with that top wave, that could be the end of the game. Mushrooms. Unfortunately, no mushrooms on Baron.
The issue has honestly been this Lucian. And the build, this Lucian build, the armor pen Lucian build, is really strong when you snowball it.
Yeah.
When you're this far behind, you might as well have just gone for your standard Lucian build,
which
is what you're going to be transitioning
to
later in the game anyway.
Jin's at 300 CS as he catches his top wave. Let's see how hard he goes. Because that's a lot of gold. It's like 30 CS right there.
That's like 300 gold right there.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah. It's a big deal. It's a big deal. All right. Looks like we're just going to sit around and waste some time.
Clear
sit around
some
and
vision.
Waste some time.
And I guess they're starting Baron.
I guess so. I think it was the an accident, maybe.
I think I saw Clumsy tantrum when she was clearing the ward, and maybe that was just an accident.
She does have the Sunfire
yeah,
cape.
She does,
as well.
Yeah, she has the Sunfire cape, so it could have been that. Could have been the tears.
Man, I'm bummed out. I'm really bummed out watching this game because there's pretty much three things in the checklist here. There's mushrooms, wave control, and vision control.
And they often get two of the three. Oh, Braum.
Wow.
All right.
Fascinating.
So, Braum's dead.
I guess that's how the game's going to go.
That's the thing is that you know, sure, you have all this AoE damage and all this wave clear and the siege potential, but you get a binding on your Lux. You chain that with a binding on your Morgana, who's 110 and 5, by the way. Not exactly having a great game.
Finding it again. Here's another one. Shield. Ulti. Big one. Finds it onto the Teemo. That's the shutdown.
That's big.
Second death of the game. A double kill from Jin. Jin's lining these up. Finds four. A huge four shot coming out from Jin. There's the Lux. Puts out some damage onto the Ori, but it's not over yet. Can Poppy get in there? She's looking for the shield.
Jin, you're out of range.
She gets it. She gets it. Jin flashes over it. Clumsy gets in. Knocked back. Immediate peel. That's going to be it for now.
Well, whew. And that all started with their support getting caught. Gets caught, gets one shot. And then the engage, the counter engage by the Orianne ulti. Only caught three people, but one of them was Teemo. Teemo got one shot, wasn't putting out any damage in the team fights, and that's mucho importante, if I do say so myself.
Is that what you say yourself?
Yeah.
Mucho importante?
Mucho importante. Importante.
Well, the longest game so far of Solo Queue Sisters has been a close one, coming up on 50 minutes.
I wonder if we're
going
to make it to the hour mark. I hope not. Not that I don't want to, you know, keep doing this, but... Your boy got to go to work soon.
Another Elder Dragon.
Elder Drake is not even necessarily that good and that powerful of an objective. I swear to God, I'm going to have a stroke. It's honestly not that powerful of an objective. I can't say it. It's not that strong. Elder Drake isn't that good.
Of an objective, yes.
It's not that good right now. Just because there's only two dragons that were taken over the course of the entire game.
Mm-hmm.
And just for the time... and HP that you have to invest in killing it.
Oh my god, Jelly Booger honestly caught out so many times this game. Needs to be careful. Needs to be way more careful. Okay.
This game has got to end at some point.
Yeah, it's gonna be one team fight. It's going to be one decisive
team
fight.
Oh yeah, we're absolutely at the point where one decisive team fight. The last one... almost was, and then...
Honestly, being in this situation as a shot caller, like, this is my dream. Oh, my God, Braum, what are you doing? Being in a shock collar, like, in this situation is my dream, because you have so much room to outplay a team by using your, like, map movements. Teemo needs to be very careful. Really good E from the Lux to separate the teams there. If their team decided to go in, that would have been a prime opportunity. Lux is running low on mana right now. And she's not doing a lot with those E's right now.
Maybe they'll back up. No, it doesn't look like they're going to back up. Braum's back in base.
Both teams don't really know what to do, to be honest. It sounds kind of rude, but they don't really know what to do. They're kind of just, like, waiting for someone to make a massive mistake. And don't know what to say, because it can go either way right now. There's not a whole lot of analysis that can happen. Like, there's things that they could be doing, but it's the same things they could have been doing all game. Like, look at that. Teemo just walked up into the Braum right beside him. And that's going to start the fight. Poppy goes in deep, finds on Clumsy. Clumsy looking for an ultimate deep, but there's nobody to follow back
only
up on it.
Orianna.
Morgana gets ulted, as does the Teemo. And Clumsy turns around to try and pop and some defensives. Lux is coming with an ultimate. If she finds it, it'll be great, but it doesn't look like it's going to hit anybody, actually. And this is almost certainly going to be the game for Team Mars. There comes the connection as well. Yep, that's going
to
be it.
There, that has
ladies
to be.
And gentlemen, with a huge mid wave, they should be able to
Did
clean it up.
Did they see it? Did they see it? Guys? Go mid. Go mid. Go mid.
I don't understand. Okay.
They're going to take Dragon? Go mid. Their whole team's dead.
Okay.
At least take the inhibitor. Like, at least get the inhibitor.
There's 40 seconds left. On.
Amumu's dead for 40 seconds. Teemo for 35.
3 out of 4 people on the team that weren't the support were dead for 40 seconds.
They could have ended the game.
Yes, they could have.
Right then. Looks and like now they're just going to walk into two Teemo shrooms.
They can go for Baron. They can go for Baron. It's okay. If they get both, that's okay.
Sure. I feel like the Nexus is probably better. Orianna, what are you backing for?
Okay, so they're not going to get both. Okay.
Oh.
This is an opportunity because they based so late and they walked over those shrooms. They know exactly where they are. They can get...
Blue team can go
yeah,
and
they can
Baron.
They can rush Baron right now, especially because it's a huge bottom wave. And if they make the call to show two people bottom right now,
there's a bunch of percentage HP damage.
Probably going to commit seppuku if they show this Orianna on top of the Braum.
I love the support solo split pushing bottom. That's
fine.
That's one
that's
of my favorite
strats. That's the best case situation here, to be honest. Oh, you greedy. You greedy girl. You greedy girl.
Oh.
You greedy girl. Call. Call it. Somebody call it. Go Baron. Go
I'm
Baron.
Watching for pings.
Look at the Baron. Look at the Baron.
The pings
Look
down.
At the Baron. Look at the Baron.
Guys. Girls. Ladies, please. And it's just Morgana getting caught.
This game went from being so good to so bad. Ladies.
This Jhin is so strong. So much stronger than the Lucian. Stronger than the Lux.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
The Orianna also stronger than the Lux. And then they're making a play on... Oh, and
wow, good flash.
Okay.
Good flash. That saved the game
but
right there.
But that's an important chunk.
Ooh, can he find it?
No.
Nope.
Whiffs 2 out of 4.
All right, looks like they're going for the tower.
There's two heavily chunked Lux coming from base. They should be able to get the tower. Yep. Hopefully the inhibitor finally
cracked
open the
base. They've got that Elder.
They don't have a minion wave to push for the rest with.
No, they don't. They could easily go back on out.
And they didn't take advantage of the top wave when it was pushed up against that tier 2 tower on blue side. And so now they've got this huge wave pushing against them all the way up back by their base.
Yeah. I think bottom side is going to push in again as well. So blue team again has an opportunity to go for Baron before that mid wave pushes in. And Poppy does cancel her recall. Orianna's at the base. Orianna does not have TP. Remember, she took her cleanse, or took a barrier, sorry. Amumu looking for an engage. Pink Rainbow super low. And instead, they're going to go for mid. I don't agree. I don't know what they're trying to do.
Baron
could
be dead by now.
Yeah, I don't know what they're trying to do.
You could even put your Morgana or Lucian or something, Morgana or Teemo even in the mid lane to sort of put them off your scent. And then the rest of you four-man the Baron. Although there is a red ward on that in that, just at the mouth of the pit. Oh, mama.
Cleared.
Are they going to do it?
They've cleared vision. They might try and bait. They might try and bait. Wait for the blue trinkets. Only one blue trinket on cooldown.
Yeah, four blue trinkets, only one of them off cooldown and hasn't been used. It's in base. They've got a big wave pushing for them in the bottom lane. Teemo's flanking.
Yeah, that's a huge wave in the bottom lane.
But
let's wait and see who pulls the trigger, because I cannot get in the mind of these teams right now. I'm having a hard time.
Whoa!
Chocoberry.
Okay. Well, there's an opening.
They could just commit to something now.
Commit to the game.
Commit to anything.
That's their wave clear. You've got
anything.
A super
Look,
minion.
They're running back and forth. Okay, finally they're going Baron. It's fine. Go Baron.
I mean,
get
sure.
the Baron. Take it. Take it, take it, take it. Elder Dragon's done. Elder Dragon will be up in 2 minutes. Take that if you want to. And then
Go take another Elder Dragon. It's really not worth it. They do this so slowly.
It is a very late Baron. 55 minutes into the game.
And they did it! Clumsy. Getting ballsy.
Ooh. These mushrooms have really been a non-factor this game.
Yeah, Braum upgraded her trinket. I don't notice when, but here we are 56 minutes into the game and Braum upgraded her trinket. So that's good. It's nice to see. Whew.
Okay.
And more recalls. Okay, they have Baron. They've lost this minion wave in the bottom to Lucian. Jin is pushing the top lane by himself. That's dangerous. That's going to be a pretty sizable wave. If they can join up with him, they should be able to just push this through the tower. Are they going to do it? Lux is going to ult the wave. That's fine. Magic damage reduction from Baron buff.
Alrighty, that's one tower. See what they do. They're going for it. Fi doesn't connect. Braum doesn't connect either. Here, I like this, but I feel like you should do any waves there. Okay.
Alright, Poppy
doesn't hit anything though.
Pretty substantially. Braum with the shield the wrong way.
It's only the wrong way if it's blocking something. There's another huge pick from Chocoberry.
Alright.
Taking the game into her own hands. Oh,
now Morgana dead.
A lot of damage coming up. They lined
so
up, burning down the front line. Poppy sends the ultimate into just
the tower,
Lux,
guys.
I believe.
Get the tower.
Teemo's coming back with home guards. Team guard. Teemo gonna wipe this up. I think that the blue team can hold on here. But look at the super minions holding down the base. Teemo does so much damage. Lucian, clean the waves. There we go. Teemo goes in. Oh, gets just one shot.
Morgana's dead.
He should have blinded
Lucian
the Jin.
Versus Jin.
Oh, no, it's done.
And that's got to be it.
Yeah, it's done.
That's got to be it.
It's done. So,
please.
We're done. So,
please.
It's done. So,
please. Jin, auto attack. Auto attack it. Yes. 58 minutes and 45 seconds, and Mars comes out victorious in the lower bracket, in the redemption bracket finals, to go to the finals. To play against Jupiter.
Goodness.
In the finals.
At least they got a lot of practice there. They got a lot of synergy. They're going to be able to work a little bit better together in the future, I believe, since they've gotten that practice. They've gotten that experience through that series. Hopefully that will carry on to the next time around. Because that